Hello, everybody. Welcome to ABC Science. My name is Factually, Contractually, and Scientifically Mike. I'm an engineer that breaks down shows on the internet. Today, we're reviewing one of my favorite Round the Twist episodes. That was probably the worst clap I've ever done ever. Okay, hang on. Today, we're reviewing one of my favorite Round the Twist episodes. Have you ever,
ever felt like this? No, literally no. Things happen. Are you
going round the twist? If you haven't seen Round the Twist, it's sort of like if Goosebumps was Australian and on acid. It's genuinely so strange. I really don't understand how the ABC got away with showing this to kids. There's even an episode about a fish, which I've actually already made a video on. In today's episode, two characters literally, and I mean this literally, they lose their minds. They literally get sucked out and lost. I wonder how that's gonna happen. Let's relive the chaos and see how the science checks out. So this episode is all about Bronson, and in my opinion, all the best episodes are Bronson-centric. His older siblings, twins Linda and Pete, are pissy because he's roped them into helping him with his science project.
We've all got to make sacrifices for science.
That's what I imagine I sound like, by the way. Well, we've all got to make sacrifices for science.
Easy for you to say. You tricked the school geek into doing a science project for you.
Number one, Anthony's not a geek. B, I didn't trick him. And fourthly, he offered to help.
Fourthly, this kid's a genius.
Let's go do some science.
We have our antagonist, Gribbs, who's the school bully, making fun of them. And Bronson's also roped in genius kid Anthony. These two have a sort of Back to the Future relationship where Bronson is Marty McFly and Anthony is Doc Brown, and their DeLorean is a machine that reads brainwaves. Anthony's super keen to help because A, he's a nerd, very relatable content, and B, he likes Linda.
So he could spend time with Linda, who he loves.
But Linda's like, absolutely not. Drama. So the science experiment is that our professors want to know if twins can actually read each other's minds. This is exciting science. Will Anthony and Bronson be the first to find proof of twin telepathy? So in the show, they're using these headsets to read brainwaves, but in the real world, these are called EEG headsets. Bonus points if you know what EEG stands for. 3, 2, 1. Electroencephalogram. Oh my God, he knows that? Yeah, everybody.
Now, the headsets have been monitoring your brainwaves all night, so it should be just a matter of taking a few finer readings.
So our brains have specific wave patterns that are different when you're awake or asleep. And these are used to diagnose neurological conditions like epilepsy or sleep disorders.
We'll need a partial vacuum, so... Nozzle!
Nozzle!
Anthony sticks a nozzle up Linda's nose for the final reading, and just imagine a pen going up your nose into your brain.
Minor glitch, gang. I'll just recalibrate the potentiometer. Okay. Probably voltage lag.
We've got Anthony saying partial vacuum, voltage lag, and recalibrate the potentiometer. So there's lots of science happening here, and it's actually quite delicious.
Here's the problem, Ant.
No, stop!
No! That shit is so fucking nasty.
Ew!
I think one of the most traumatizing things about this episode is not the fact that their brains are not in their bodies anymore, it's the fact that the brains got sucked through the nose. The ancient Egyptians used to do this by shoving a chisel up the nose, cracking the skull, scrambling the brains, and letting them pour out. I wouldn't worry about your brain being sucked through your nose, especially if you've got such a big brain like mine. I'm so cheeky. Brains are too big. Basically, they weigh 1.3 kilos, and pulling that through a 1 centimeter cavity, it's not gonna happen.
Okay, thinking cap time. Brain's there, body's there. Tricky.
Oh, I must have been out of my head to agree to this.
I'm personally very impressed that these brains are technically still alive because they're not getting any blood supply and therefore oxygen. While Anthony repairs the machine, Bronson takes the bodies and brains somewhere less public. He controls their bodies with a remote control, but in the real world, you'd be using electrical stimulation to activate the muscles. Now, interestingly, we do see bodies surviving without brains. Cockroaches can actually survive for weeks without their heads. The problem arises when they need to eat, and they can do this because their brain is actually spread out across their whole body. in the 1940s, a chicken was kept alive for 18 months after losing its head and was fed directly down its throat. I don't love that for the chicken. Shoving food down the chicken's neck.
That's like disgusting.
This is more fun than Mario Brothers.
So drama, drama, drama. Porridge gets in the controller. The bodies run away from Bronson all the way back to the school lab. What follows is a complex and highbrow and very round-the-twist series of events. The bodies malfunction and Pete throws the brain bucket onto a miniature rocket. The fish tank water causes the rocket to short circuit, which actually kind of makes scientific sense, and then it launches. The rocket takes off with the brain bucket attached and flies up out of the hood into the outside sky, very high. The rocket runs out of fuel, parachutes down and lands in the tip. I haven't finished yet. The brains try to jump back to town and accidentally hitch a ride on a skateboard. The cool skater kid flips the brains into a butchery. The brains are sold as animal brains and taken to a barbecue. But at the barbecue, a little girl takes a ripper of a kick at the brains, flinging them into a cricket match. Yeah, hang on. Was the yodeling music necessary? Let me ask the audience. Then the brains hit an uncooked chicken, and while sitting on the chicken, they fly across the park to a flushing toilet. What is this show? I mean, honestly, make it make sense. So after all of this, the question on everyone's lips is the chicken still good to eat? It's absolutely not still good to eat. It lands on a public toilet, be serious. Disgusting! The brains find their way back to Bronson by literally hitting him on the head. But now the bodies are missing, and that's bloody Gribbs's fault. Bronson goes ham on the remote control in what Gribbs describes as revenge of the nerds. And while I hate Gribbs, this is where I start to have ethical concerns about everyone controlling Linda and Pete's bodies. I love that this is where I draw the line. Like, all the rest of the stuff was fine. By the end of the episode, 4 brains have been removed, 3 have been put back in their original bodies by reversing the machine. Sorry, Gribbs, for missing out on that one.
It's okay, Gribbs. Don't lose your head.
And Bronson's team wins the science fair. Once again, the twists win and Gribbs loses. Eat shit, Gribbs. Overall, I'd rate this episode 11 out of 10. The extra point is because of the toilet humour. The literal toilet humour. This is probably Round the Twist's most science-y episode, so I find it interesting how they depict intelligence. It sets up Anthony as this super nerdy school genius and Bronson as a bit dumb.
I've got an idea.
Please, Bronson. I doubt that your primary school science is going to solve the biggest medical challenge in human history.
But the thing is, Bronson isn't dumb. He's actually a pretty good problem solver. It's him that comes up with the idea with how to put the brains back. And that's basically what science is, making up stuff and then testing it. The writers are less kind to Gribbs, who starts dumb and ends dumb, but that's fine because we hate him.
Gribbs, you don't understand.
Understanding's overrated.
Understanding is overrated. At first I was like, that's dumb, Gribbs. But then I was like, maybe that's a good lesson for watching TV. Sometimes you just gotta leave your brain at home. Thank you all so much for watching. Make sure you check out my other Round the Twist video right here. And of course, like this video, leave us a comment, and subscribe to ABC Science.